Alright, what's good? What's going on? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be reviewing the Air Jordan 1 Shattered Backboard. Alright, let's get into it. Okay, so my first impressions of this shoe, I am a fan of this silhouette. It's easy to wear with anything. These colors go with a lot of different things I have in my closet already, hoodies and stuff. But even more, the story behind this shoe made me an even bigger fan of this particular colorway. If you don't know the particular history of this colorway, let me set the scene for you.
The year was 1985. A 22-year-old Michael Jordan was a rising star, and his fame was rising at a feverish pitch as well. After just being named Rookie of the Year, and nearly a month away from releasing his first signature shoe with Nike, he participated in an exhibition game in Italy. Donning the black, white, and orange jersey of Trist, and lacing up his unreleased Chicago Air Jordan 1s, Michael put on a show that night, scoring over 30 points. But the absolute highlight came in the fourth quarter when Jordan took flight and threw down a thunderous dunk. A dunk so powerful, Jordan shattered the glass backboard. Nearly 30 years later, Nike brand commemorated this event by releasing the Shattered Backboard colorway.
These released back in June the 27th of 2015. Needless to say, they sold out immediately. Funny enough, these released alongside the Jordan 31 that also donned a shattered backboard color. They don't get talked about enough. I'm not a fan of that particular silhouette. I know they're great basketball shoes from all the reviews and everything that I hear. I'm not a fan. So I guess it makes sense why they're not talked about that much. All right, with the history lesson over, let's talk about how you can actually get yourself a pair of these. All right, so on screen right now, I have all the seller's contact information, where to reach them at, name, number, all that fun stuff. It took about 1.5 weeks for me to get this. Really quick shipping, DHL. I had these shipped with a couple other shoes, so they got shipped in a bundle. And like I said, that's super fast. Yeah. Price is $125 and about $133 after you do, depending on how you pay. I pay PayPal, and once you pay the taxes and fees, about $133. But I say that beats paying resale price right now. Price on the box is $160, so these actually came out. When they came out, they were $160. So, I mean, you're getting a deal. These look flawless to me. If you have any questions or concerns about ordering this shoe, or any other shoe in that matter, please comment down below, or you can feel free to reach out to me. All my contact information is in the description. I'll get back to you as quickly as possible. As always, thanks for watching. If you found this video informative, you know, please share some love by liking, sharing, commenting down below. Also, could you guys do me a huge favor? Comment down below what kind of shoe you want me to review next, whether it's a Yeezy. I have the Jordan 4 sale that's on the way. I have a couple other shoes, some off-whites that I have coming in, some Balenciaga, so look forward to that. But like I said, if you like the video, comment, like, share, and feel free to subscribe. You can always unsubscribe later. But that's all I got. It's been fun. I'm Poncho Mac, and until the next one, peace.